Andy, you've brought us to Caspian Way in Purfleet to talk about the Bellis Chase School. Could you please tell us why you've actually brought us here?
Well, a lot of people don't even know this area exists, and yet we've had hundreds and hundreds of houses being built in Purfleet, and it just seems like the council seems to be unaware of this area as well. There are also plans for several thousand more houses to be built in West Thurrock and Purfleet, and they haven't got a school to go to now, a secondary school. Now the rush decision to build the school in Aveley has been taken. They've got no secondary school for their children. They'll have to travel several miles to get to school.
Right, could you say why you're unhappy about that decision?
I certainly can. It was a rush decision. None of the residents here were informed about it. Indeed, I wasn't informed about it either as their ward councillor. And the whole point is this area has now got several more, hundreds more properties than it had a little while ago. And in years to come, there'll be thousands of properties built in West Thurrock and Purfleet, and they'll have no secondary school to go to.
You personally favoured the former London Fire Brigade Sports Centre in Purfleet Road as a possible site for the rebuild, but members of your own group are in favour of the possibility of a new football arena and sports village for Grays Athletic at that site. Was that the only alternative?
That was the only one that the council found as an alternative, and that's right between Purfleet and Aveley, so it was a better site, a much bigger site, and a site which could have fitted in a sports stadium as well. So it was an ideal site for both purposes.
Do you think that the residents of Purfleet and West Thurrock have been ignored and given no input into this decision?
Absolutely. When we actually called it in so the council would have to think about it again, I made this point. All we wanted was the residents of Purfleet and West Thurrock to be spoken to be consulted. But they haven't been consulted, and nor have I. That's why I'm absolutely furious about this decision that's been rushed through without any consideration at all for West Thurrock and Purfleet. The problem with this area is they haven't got enough facilities as it is. We desperately need a school, and now we're not even going to get that.
What happens next, or is that a final decision?
Well, it looks like it's a final decision, but what we'll do is carry on campaigning for a new school in Purfleet, because it'll definitely be needed in the future, and it's best to start planning for it now, rather than wait until people in Purfleet got nowhere to go at all.